So are we the light or are we the light bulb? Hey, it's Dr. McLean, Vital Energy Chiropractic. When it comes to your health, I'd really recommend to look at not just your physical health, but also look at your spiritual, mental, emotional, whatever you'd like to call it. And what I mean by that is you have, let's say, electricity, and you've got a light bulb, but you need those together. If you want to produce light, you need both components. You can't just have electricity without something to animate. So we have our physical body, we've got our skin and our muscle, our tissues, our bones, and even the physical parts of our brain. We've got this spiritual side, this electrical side, if you will, that has to animate those components. And this is when somebody's pronounced dead. They're not pronounced dead when their heart stops. It's when the electrical component or that spiritual component stops. And you can take somebody that, let's say they weigh 150 pounds and they're 80 years old or 90 years old and they pass away from natural consequences. If you weigh them right before they die and then right after they die, they still weigh the same amount. So what's missing is that spiritual component. So when it comes to your health, this is something I think is greatly overlooked. We, number one, we don't give our bodies enough credit for the ability to be able to heal. And we can heal anything, you know, within physical realms, right? If we cut our arm off, we're probably not going to grow that back, but we can heal almost any malady that you can think of. But we got to put into that spiritual component. So I would recommend do something to allow yourself to adapt better to your circumstances. We're all going to have stress. And stress in itself isn't a bad thing. Stress can help motivate us to go do things in life that are important. We can set goals that give us a little stress to help keep us going and move us towards those things that we desire in life. And that's really important. But we can have things like family stress and job stress and financial stress. And we can get overwhelmed and that can really tax our bodies and that can affect our health. So I would really recommend to have some type of a component to allow yourself to adapt better to that mental, emotional, stressful part of your life. And so that could be done through meditation, it could be done through prayer, it could be done through visualization, it could be done through breathing. Journaling, really something very simple is journaling. It just helps you be more in tune with your thoughts and your emotions and what you're thinking and how you're adapting to life. And if you want help on this, please let me know. But have some type of component of that. Now, this is why I think chiropractic is the best form of healthcare and the research support this as well. But chiropractic combines the man or woman mental with the physical, right? We're removing interference from the spine so that the mental component of your body can communicate and animate your body better and also allow you to adapt better to health and to life. So I would highly recommend to have some type of whatever you want to call it, mental, emotional, spiritual component to your health and make it a habit. You can start with 5 minutes a day. It doesn't take much. Start there. And you could even look at, let's say for me, working out, physically working out, I consider part of my spiritual health because it helps bring down the stress hormones. It helps occupy my body so my mind can run more free and think of solutions in other areas of our life. But I would also include that spiritual component, like I said, writing, journaling, visualization, meditation, again, whatever works for you.